Solving equations by factoring. Must equal zero. Before we factor, the equation must be equal to zero. If it's not, then we need to solve so that we have everything on one side and zero on the other. To make factoring easier, we want the x squared or y squared or whatever the variable may be, that's our first term, to be positive. Let's take a look at our examples. In example one, we have 5x squared equal to 2x plus 16. So that means that we want to move this stuff here over to the other side. So we're going to do that by subtracting 2x and negative 16. So we're going to get 5x squared minus 2x minus 16 equal to 0. We'll set up our two sets of parentheses. And there's only one way of factoring 5, so we're going to have x and 5x. And the thing that comes to mind for 16 for me right now is 4. So I'm going to go ahead and put 4 in there and see what happens. My outside term, we're going to get 4x. Our inside term, we're going to have 20x, and we'll be subtracting because our last term is negative. That is not going to give me 2. That's all way too big. So that means we need to do something else. So the easiest thing to do would be to change out our 4, and let's make it a 2 and an 8. Let's put my 2 here and my 8 here. So my outside term now is 8x. My inside term would be 10x, and we're subtracting. That would give me a negative 2x. I even have the right signs, so that means my plus goes here and my negative goes here. So now that I have those factored correctly, I can now solve. I set x minus 2 equal to 0 and 5x plus 8 equal to 0. Now I add 2 to both sides here. That gives me x equal to 2. Solve my other one. I'll subtract 8 from both sides. I get 5x equal to negative 8. Divide by 5. And x equals negative 8/5. So my two answers then are x is equal to negative 8/5 and 2. Let's take a look at our other example. So the first thing that I want to do is I want to move those two over to the other side so that I have everything on one side. Or this one actually might be easier, is if we just move this over, that way it is positive when I go to factor it. So we're going to do that. We're going to add 2x squared to both sides. 0 equal to 2x squared plus x minus 3. Doesn't really matter what side my 0 is on, it's still equal to 0. So I'm going to do my two sets of parentheses. Only one way of factoring 2. And there's only one way of factoring 3. I don't think I want to multiply my 2 times my 3, so I'm going to put my 3 in with the same box as my 2, and I'll put 1 in my other one. So now I've got 2x minus 3x. How about a negative x? We want a positive, so that means I need to change my signs here. That will give me a positive. That means my negative goes in the second box. My positive goes in my first. Okay, now that I have that, I can now set my two factors equal to 0. So I have 2x plus 3 equal to 0 and x minus 1 equal to 0. Solving for the first one, I'm going to subtract 3 from both sides. I get 2x equal to negative 3 divide by 2, and x is going to equal a negative 3/2. Solving my other one, I'm going to add 1 to both sides. I'll get x equal to 1. So my solutions then are going to be x equal to negative 3/2 and 1. And I'm done.